Go into all the world and proclaim the gospel to every creature. Alleluia. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Our celebration of Easter continues today with the feast of St. Mark, the Evangelist, and also a secondary apostle of the Church. We're offering this Mass for the good estate of Charles Vincent. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you have revealed yourself as the way to the Father.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You have poured out on your people the Spirit of truth.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are the Good Shepherd leading us to eternal life.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory God in nations is Deo. Glory to God in the highest. And on earth, peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray.
O God, you raised up St. Mark, your evangelist, and endowed him with the grace to preach the gospel. Grant, we pray, that we may so profit from his teaching as to follow faithfully in the footsteps of Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
Peace to all who are in Christ.
gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to the 11, "Go out to the whole world, proclaim the good news to all creation. He who believes and is baptized will be saved. He who does not believe will be condemned. These are the signs that will be associated with believers. In my name they will cast out devils. They will have the gift of tongues. They will pick up snakes in their hands and be unharmed should they drink deadly poison. They will lay their hands on the sick, who will recover." And so the Lord Jesus, after he had spoken to them, was taken up to heaven. There at the right hand of God he took his place, while they going out preached everywhere, the Lord working with them and confirming the word by the signs that accompanied it.
The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Among the call to holiness is the call to humility, that Christ is at the centre of my life, that he must increase and I must decrease. And so we are called to live simply, using the goods of this world in a balanced and temperate way, and where possible, always for the glory of God and the service of his holy church. A surrendering to God's will does not mean we live a passive existence. No, we actively share in Christ's mission to bring peace to the nations and salvation to all people of goodwill. In making himself lowly, God has now raised Jesus high, so at his name every knee shall bow and we shall call him Lord, God. Those called to the life of heaven should know that there are many people, the devil included, who want us to fall from grace. They, like roaring lions, look to devour us at the first sign of hypocrisy and double standard. Christians firm in the faith are keenly aware, or they should be keenly aware, of our own limitations. We should be seeking to mortify and purify what is weak. We should be the first to accuse ourselves in the sacrament of reconciliation. A lovely little thing in the primary school, they say, when you point a finger, there are three fingers pointing back at you. So be careful. Such a humility allows for the kiss of peace, a mark of the supernatural charity, that gesture that's been passed into the primitive Eucharistic liturgy, which, when appropriate, can still be exchanged amongst the community today before we receive Holy Communion. It's a great sign of our Easter peace, that words of Jesus that we heard yesterday in the Gospel, "Peace be with you," those first words of the resurrection. St. Peter refers, of course, to St. Mark. He's a secondary apostle, he's the evangelist. He acts as Peter's interpreter in Rome. Peter calls Mark his son. Maybe not literally, but spiritually, perhaps like a bishop to a priest, or a priest to his people. Mark speaks of this universal mandate, an imperative to preach the gospel, to build up the kingdom of God, even here and now, even though it won't come in its fullness until the second coming. This presents a challenge to us. It means we can't be too parochial. Our vision, and if you read the front of the newsletter, so if we're thinking about our mission and vision, our vision has to be outward as we seek to play our part in gathering the nations into the beasts of God's kingdom. And this then, of course, includes ecumenism, firstly with the Eastern Church, including the Coptic Church, which we believe was founded by Bishop St. Mark and is the place in Alexandria where we believe he was martyred. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept
the
sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
As we venerate the glory of St. Mark, we offer you, Lord, the sacrifice of praise and humbly beseech you that your church may always persevere in the preaching of the gospel through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up the hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For you have built your church to stand firm on apostolic foundations, to be a lasting sign of your holiness on earth, and offer all humanity your heavenly teaching. Therefore now and for ages unending, with all the hosts of angels, we sing to you with all our hearts, crying out as we acclaim,
Holy, holy,
Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his risen disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection, until you come on again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the sacred passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an temple offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Peter and St. Paul, St. Mark, with St. Mary Magdalene, St. Martha, St. Richard of Chichester, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis our Pope and Richard our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom, that we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, for whom you bestow the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Saviour's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, and thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now
and ever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, if you live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that what we have received from your holy altar may sanctify us and make us strong in the faith of the gospel which St. Mark proclaimed, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Tomorrow is the transfer solemnity of St. George, martyr and patron of England. I know the world out there was getting gloomy about St. George on Saturday, but of course that was still in the octave of Easter. And without Easter, without the resurrection, there are no saints. So St. George very joyfully gives way to our Lord's resurrection. And the next available day of the celebration is tomorrow, the 26th of April. So wish you a very happy feast day and the patron of your country. Father Roger shall be celebrating Mass with you tomorrow morning. I'm at the school. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.